वेलकम, आई एम प्रोफेसर एस आर चाकने, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर ऑफ एग्रोनॉमी एट सदगुरु कॉलेज ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर मिरजगांव. टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द लेक्चर नंबर 8, दैट इज द क्रॉप एडाप्टेशंस. इन दिस लेक्चर वी हैव टू स्टडी द डिफरेंट क्रॉप एडाप्टेशंस टू मॉइस्चर स्ट्रेस कंडीशन. फर्स्टली व्हाट इज मीन बाय द ड्रॉट एडाप्टेशन. सो the drought adaptation is defined as the ability of crop to grow satisfactorily under the water stress, that is known as the drought adaptation. So in simple way, the drought adaptation, that is the ability of the plant to grow in a well manner under the water stress condition, that is known as the drought adaptation. Then adaptation is a structural or the functional modification in plant to survive and reproduce in a particular environment is known as the adaptation. There are different types of the adaptations are there. First one, that is the escaping drought. Then second adaptation, that is a drought resistance. In that there are two types of the drought resistance are there. First one is the drought avoidance. In that conserving water under the water stress condition, and second one, improving the water uptake, that means the water spenders. Then the second type of the drought adaptation under the drought resistance, that is the drought tolerance. In that first one is the mitigating state stress and second one is the high tolerance. Firstly we will discuss about the escaping the drought. In that, the some crop which having the short duration of life cycle so that they can escape the drought condition, and these are called as the ephemeral plant. That means those plants which having the very short life cycle, that is known as the ephemerals, and these ephemeral plant, they can survive under the drought condition or they can escape the drought, that is known as the ephemerals. Then the short duration pulses like the cowpea, green gram, Bengal gram, that can be included in the category of the ephemeral. That means these crops which having the short life duration, for example the crops are the cowpea, green gram, Bengal gram, which are categorized under the ephemerals. Then these plants have no mechanism for overcoming the moisture stress and are therefore not a drought resistant. Then these ephemeral plants which doesn't having the mechanism for overcoming the moisture stress and therefore they are not a drought resistant plant. So this is about the escaping the drought. Then second one, that is the drought resistance. Under that, first one is the avoiding the stress. So what is the stress avoidance? That means it is the ability of the plant to maintain the favorable water balance and turgidity even when exposed to the drought condition, that is known as the avoiding of the stress. So the stress avoidance, that means it is the ability of plant to maintain the water balance even they are exposed to the drought condition, that is known as the stress avoidance. Then avoid the stress either by conserving the water, that is also known as the water saver, or by improving the water uptake, that is also known as the water spenders. Then next point is mechanism to conserve the water, that means water saver. Then it includes the stomatal mechanism, then the deposition of the lipid on the leaves, then reduction in the leaf area. Then fourth one, that is the leaf surface characters like the thick cuticle, then waxy surface, as well as the presence of the spines on the leaves. Then increase the photosynthetic efficiency, then presence of the awns, and last one, that is the water storage in the plant, for example the pineapple. So these are the various mechanisms which are used to conserve the water. That means these mechanisms are mainly utilized for the water savers. Then first one, that is the stomatal mechanism. So what is the stomatal mechanism? In which the drought resisting varieties are capable of regulating the stomatal mechanism and closing the stomata more rapidly in the early morning when the moisture stress is at its minimum and photosynthesis can be proceed with the least loss of the water. So this is about the stomatal mechanism, in which the whatever the drought resisting varieties are there, and these varieties which are capable of the regulation of the stomatal mechanism, as well as they are capable of the regulation of the closing of the stomata more rapidly in the morning and when they are is at the moisture stress condition, again the minimum as well as the photosynthesis can be proceed with the least loss of the water. Then second one, that is the lipid deposit on the leaves. In that, the soybean, sorghum, they reduces the water loss by the depositing lipids on the plant surfaces under the moisture stress condition. Then third mechanism in the water saver, that is the reduction in the leaf area, in which the plant reduces the transpiration by reducing the leaf area. If the leaf area of the crop is reduces, then it also helps to reduces the transpiration, that means the loss of water from the aerial parts of the plant. Then the individual leaf size is reduced as the leaf expansion is very sensitive to the moisture stress. That means if the leaves are the expanded, then in that case the more transpiration which is takes place, then the leaf size is reduced, there is the less transpiration which is occur as the leaf expansion that is very sensitive to the moisture stress condition. Then in grasses, the leaves roll due to the moisture stress and thus reduces the area exposed to the solar radiation. Then very important example, that is the reduction of the leaf area naturally. In case of the grasses, the leaves are rolled due to the moisture stress condition automatically, and due to that it reduces the area of leaf that is exposed to the solar radiation. This is the best example to shows the reduction in the leaf area. Then in case of the leguminous plant, that shows the parahelionastic movement, that is the leaves are oriented parallel to the sun rays and thus avoiding the load of the solar radiation. Then the another example, that is the reduction in leaf area, that is the example is the leguminous crop, and this leguminous crop that shows the parahelionastic movement, that means the leaves which are oriented parallel to the sun rays, and due to that it avoids the load of the solar radiation, and in this way the transpiration through this leguminous crop that can be minimized. Then next one, or next mechanism, that is the leaf surface characteristics. Then there are the various leaf characteristics and which also affect on the water saver plant, as the various leaf morphological characteristics of the leaves which are used to reduce the transpiration rate, and they may influence the survival of plants under the drought condition. Then the leaf characteristic, as the leaves with the thick cuticle, then waxy surface, as well as the presence of the spines on the leaves, these are very common as well as the effective in reducing the transpiration by the plant surfaces. So the various leaf characteristic, as the presence of the thick cuticle, then waxy surface, as well as the presence of the spine, these are the important characteristics of the water saver plant. Then increased photosynthetic efficiency, in that C4 and the calm plant, they are highly drought tolerant crops. Then what is the calm plant? That is the translucent acid metabolism plants. They are very drought tolerant crop. Then effect of the awns. Then awn varieties are more resistant than the awnless varieties. Then again, the awn varieties, these are more resistant to the water stress condition than the awnless varieties. That means the transpiration which is minimum in case of the awn variety as compared to the awnless varieties. Then next one, that is the water storage in the plant. So So this is an adaptive mechanism. The leaves of pineapple contain substantial amount of water in a special non-chlorophyllous tissue, which is utilized during the drought condition. Then we have to discuss the mechanism to improve the water uptake, that is known as the water spender. In that we have to study the different mechanism as first one, that is the efficient root system, second one, root shoot ratio, third one, increase in the liquid phase conductance, and fourth one is the osmotic adjustment. So these four mechanisms we have to study to improve the water uptake of plant, that means we also known as the water spender. In that first mechanism we have to study here, that is the efficient root system. In that condition, deep, well branched and the rapidly growing root system that helps in absorbing the more moisture by exploiting more volume of the soil. It helps in drought resistance without losing the productivity of the crop. Then the crop which having the deep root system, then they are well branched and they should be rapidly growing root system, and this type of the root system, they helps in absorbing the more moisture by exploiting the more volume of the soil, and again it helps in drought resistance without losing the productivity of the crop. Then second mechanism in case of the water saver, that is the root shoot ratio. In that condition, the higher the root shoot ratio, more the plant is resistant. If the root to shoot ratio, that is more, in that case the more plant is resistant to the moisture stress. That is because of more absorption area than that of the transpiring area. That means if the root area, that is more, in that case the absorption of water is more than that of the transpiration area. So the root shoot ratio, which is very important mechanism. Then third one, that is the increase in the lipid phase conductance. That means the lowering of the resistance to water can be achieved by increasing their diameter of the xylem vessels or their diameter. Then next mechanism, that is the osmotic adjustment. If the plants which having the ability to lower their osmotic potential in response to slowly developing deficits which are useful, then the leaves, then hypocotyles, roots and spikelets which have shown to adjust osmotically in some species, then the osmotic adjustment helps in maintain the turgor as a water deficit which are develop. Then this osmotic adjustment which enables the plant to maintain the turgor as the water deficit which are developed. Then next one, that is the osmotic adjustment that increases the translocation as well as it helps in increase the grain yield of the crop. In this way the osmotic adjustment which plays the important role as it increases the translocation of the moisture as well as the different nutrient from one part to the other part of the plant, and it also helps in increasing the grain yield also. Then the second one, that is the drought tolerance. Then what is mean by the drought tolerance? So the drought tolerance, it can be defined as the tolerance of the plant to a level of stress at which the 50% of the cells are die. That is known as the drought tolerance. So the drought tolerance is a plant tolerance of the plant to a such a level that at which the 50% of the cells of the plant which are dry, which are die, that is known as the drought tolerance. Then the drought tolerance is either by the mitigating the stress or by showing the stress. And second one, that is the high degree of the tolerance. In that first one is the mitigating stress. So it is by resisting the dehydration and by maintenance of the high osmotic pressure by the accumulation of the high amount of the solute which are takes place. Then the leaves with a thick cuticle will resist cell collapse. Then first one, that is the resistant to the dehydration, that means avoiding the cell collapse after loss of turgor. That means this is the morphological adaptation in which the avoidance of the cell collapse, that is, takes place after the loss of the turgor pressure, that is known as the resistant to the dehydration. Then a high internal osmotic pressure that can be obtained by the accumulation of a sufficient solute to prevent the dangerous internal desiccation of the cells, and the plasma itself becomes more drought enduring. Then most crop plants internal osmotic pressure is at 10 to 20 atmospheric. Then the xerophytes which having the osmotic pressure, that is 30 to 40 atmosphere, and the hydrophytes plant, that means those plants which are living in the water, this having the 100 atmospheric osmotic pressure. And the xerophytes means those plants which are living in the xeric condition, that means very less amount of the rainfall receiving area. The osmotic pressure of that plant, they ranges between 30 to 40 atmosphere. Then next one, that is the prevention of the leaf collapse, in which the thick cell wall, then sunken stomata, then lipid or the waxy coating on the leaves, then presence of the spine that prevent wilting or the collapse of the leaves. Then the various characteristics which are responsible in preventing the wilting or the collapse of the leaves, these are the presence of the thick cell wall, then presence of the sunken stomata, then lipid or the waxy coating which are present on the leaves, and these factors which are responsible in preventing the wilting or the collapse of the leaves. Then second one, that is the high degree of tolerance, in that the death of plant can be avoided either by reducing the metabolic strain or the plastic strain. Mostly in under the high degree of tolerance, the death of plant that can be avoided by the reduction in the metabolic strain as well as the plastic strain also. Then the adverse influence of the drought on mechanism of plant is known as the metabolic strain. Then what is the metabolic strain? That means the adverse influence of drought on the metabolism of plant, that is known as the metabolic strain. Then next one, that is the death of cell occurs either due to the reduction in the carbon metabolism, that means the photosynthesis, or the nitrogen metabolism, that means the protein synthesis. That means the death of cell which are occur due to the two mechanism, that is the carbon mechanism or the nitrogen metabolism. That means the reduction in the photosynthesis and the protein synthesis, that will be the responsible for the death of cell in the plant. Then next one, that is the resistant to the metabolic strain, that means it is also known as the setback. Then the greater the elastic dehydration strain, greater is the danger of resulting the plastic metabolic strain. Then the cell dehydration is elastic and completely reversible up to a point beyond which it is a plastic irreversible, and therefore which is injurious to the crop growth. Then what is mean by the starvation? Starvation means ability of guard cell to remain turgid environment when the leaf cells are wilted, and is possible due to the increase in the solute of the guard cell. Then what is the starvation? The starvation, it is defined as the ability of guard cell to remain in the turgid environment or the turgid condition when the leaf cells are wilted, and it is only possible due to the increase in the solute of the guard cell. Then next one, that is the protein loss. The avoidance of the protein loss under the drought condition is the net result of two processes, that is the decreased rate of protein breakdown and increased rate of the protein synthesis, that is the known as the protein loss. Then next one, that is the avoidance or the tolerance of the direct drought induced plastic strain. Then some higher plant may show the little restriction of the transpiration during the drought and can become air air dry without suffering the permanent injury. The example is the gram or the grass that are the examples of the avoidance or the tolerance of the direct drought which is induced due to the plastic strain. Then the seeds are the seeds that are filled with the good reserve but have no vacuole can survive very long dry period, often for the many years. That means the seeds which are filled with the good reserve, that means it contains the good food material, but which doesn't having the presence of the vacuole in the seed, they can survive for the very long dry period, often for many years. Then the buds of higher plant have no vacuole and resistant to the desiccation. Then above the ground part may die, but the bulbs, tubers, corms and rhizome, they are remain in a live condition. Again, we have to discuss some desirable characteristics for the drought resistant crop. That means what are the desirable or the ideal characters of the crop which are used as a drought resistant. In that first one, the rapid germination and early establishment of the deep root. The selected crop which having the rapid germination and there should be the early establishment of the deep root, that can be the first ideal character for the drought resistant crop. Then the rapid phenological development, that means there should be the rapid vegetative growth during the early growth stages of the crop. Then it should have the developmental plasticity. Then it should have the paraheliotrophic movement, that means the movement of the plant towards the sunlight. Then the stomata sensitive to the larger vapor pressure deficit and they are insensitive to the low leaf water potential. Then the selected crops or the plant should having the ability to adjust osmotically and the large transfer of the assimilate from the stem to the grain and the dehydration tolerance, particularly the seedling as well as the grain filling stages. So these are the some desirable characters which are considered for the drought resistant crop. Thank you.